frames of ranking is from 0 to 700, from 700 to 500, from 500 to 300, from 300 to 150, to 150 to top 100, from top 100 to 50, from 50 to 30, from 30 to 10, from 10 to 2, from 2 to 1. You go back. You want to be from 0 to 500. 500 has how many points? It will be like 70 points. Okay, 70 points. You start from 0. Okay, if you win this tournament, you won 2 matches plus 1 is 3 matches. You have 1 point. Okay? In one tournament, you play 3 matches, you have 1 point. You won 3 matches, you get 1 point. Let's say you make semi-final, it's 3 points from qualifying. You make 3 and 3, 6 matches, you have 3 points. If we divide 70 by 3, it's 25 matches more, it's 25 tournaments. 25 tournaments, we multiply by 3, that's 75 matches you have to win a year. Exactly the same than the number 2 to the number 1. So every frame of ranking, if you want to break every frame of ranking, you have to win minimum 75 matches a year. 75 matches a year divided in 1 year is like 1 match every 4 or 5 days. So every tournament you play, you have to win average 3 and 3, 6 matches. But let's see that you go, you get ranking and you don't play the quali anymore. So you start from first round. So let's see that from those 25 tournaments, 12 of them you are in the main group. So we delete 36, we delete 24 matches. Okay, so 75, 24 is 50 matches. But there will come a moment that future doesn't allow you to have more points. That doesn't give more points to have better rankings. Okay, so you have to go to challenges. You start in the quali again. You start to play 2 matches qualify and plus 1 round main draw minimum, if not doesn't count. That's 3 matches again at higher level. So at the end, no matter what, you have to win 75 matches a year to break frames of ranking. And what's the problem? That the players don't have the ability to win 75 matches a year to break those frames of ranking. Because most of the players, they stay always in the same frame of ranking. Because they don't have this ability to win matches. Only the ones who goes up has this ability. Or you are a super macro player that you go, you win, you win, you win, you win, and in 4 tournaments, in 24 matches, you are from 0 to 500. You go to a challenger, you win, you win, you win, in 3 tournaments, in 15 matches, you are in 150, but 15. 3 challengers, 15 matches, and 4 futures. 5 matches is 20, 35 matches, and you are 120. You go to 2 ATP tours, you win, you win. You are top 100. But you will need 5, you will need 45 matches. Minimum, to break from 0 to top 100. But this career is impossible to do it. Okay? It's impossible. Okay? So, but let's say that from the 75 matches, you take 20% off, which is 14 matches, you go to 60. Why 25% off? Because it has the tournaments that you make a final or you break and you make good results, so you add more points. So we go to 60 matches. Okay, let's take, if you want, 10 matches less because you make a super good result. I don't know. So you go to 50 matches a year. 50 matches a year. I don't think it's enough, but let's put 50 matches a year. 50 matches a year divided in 25 tournaments is 2 matches average every tournament that you have to win. But it's not like this, the average is not working, because the average gives you the first round points. So if you win only 25 matches a year, in future you only have 25 points, you don't arrive to the next frame of ranking. You know? So it's not worth, that rule is not applied here, okay? Because you have to win 75 matches every frame of ranking. Because it's not only to add points, it's not to lose points. Yeah? Because when you are 150, you want to break top 100, you have, I don't know, 400 points, you have to add 300 more and don't lose those 400. So you have to get from the 1st of January to the 31st of January 700 points, 650, 600 points. One ATP tour give you 250. 5 matches you get 250. Average player, not the non-human players like Rafa or these guys, a normal player, imagine you have to get 700 points in 1 year. A normal player wins maybe 2 challengers, it's 10 matches, that's around 150 points, in 10 matches 150. Let's say you made second round in Grand Slam from quali in 2 of them. That's 3 and 4, 8 players. So we have 10 and 8, 18 matches. And you have 120 and second round 75, 75, 150. So you have 270. And you already play 4, 4, 8, 5, 5, 18 matches. And you are in 1/3 of what you need. You follow the amount of matches you have to win and the amount of matches the player has to have the ability to win that amount of matches in every day, any circumstances, every day against any other player, every day with different feelings, every day with different conditions, and that's ability, that's a skill. How you create that skill? Playing matches, winning matches. Winning matches against the best player, against the bad players, against the worst players, against my father, against the guy who cleans the club, against I don't get a shit. It's winning matches. It's ability. You know? And the guys who jump the frame are the guys who has this ability. And this ability has nothing to do to play well or to be prepared. It's just ability. It's just another skill. So put in your mind that if you want to go ahead in the ranking, you have to win a very amount of matches.